right. Hello, everyone. Who's ready to do a little stretching with me? We're going to start in the chair. We'll do a little bit of mat stretching. We're just going to try to open up the body a little bit today, get you a little more loose, and tell you a little bit about why we're doing all those stretches, why we're doing them. So we'll start, like I was saying, we'll start in the chair, get you going. My name is Ken, by the way. Welcome to my stretch break today, and hopefully it's a nice little break for you. We're going to start in that chair. I like to always start in the chair. We kind of work our way up, get the hip flexors, glutes stretched out after we go through some of the upper body stuff. So first thing I want to do is just take the hands, open them up nice and tall to the ceiling. We just want to reach those fingertips up. Try to take a big inhale in. And exhale. And now I want it to go the opposite way. We've stretched up. Now let's reach down. So inhale. Reach to the floor. Bring it right around. Let's come back up. Now let's clasp those hands together. We're just going to reach it up to the sky. If you don't like clasping them, you can grab one hand, or you can just put them together like this, or you can keep them apart, kind of fist together. No means trying to make it uncomfortable for anybody. Be the stretch that is best for you. You'll feel this come up through the arms here. Let's go ahead and shift that forward now. And all I want to do, I want to feel this up in the upper shoulders. So if you're clasping, you're holding it there. If you're holding the hands, just try to reach forward. Open up those shoulder blades. Good. Let's go ahead. And with that reach, go ahead and just sit the neck back a little bit. Chin goes to the ceiling. Three, two, one, bring the head back to neutral. Let's go ahead and either clasp the chair behind us, or if you can, clasp the hands together. But you want to do something so that you can open up. You want to pull the shoulder blades back, and you want to open up that chest. And then what I want you to do as we're holding that chest is take your chin and just tuck it down to the chest. You'll feel that neck stretch out as you feel the chest. Three, two, one. Go ahead and bring the neck up. We're still pulling on that chest. Nice, easy stretches. Open up those shoulder blades. Up those pectoralis muscles. Three, two, and one. Shake it out there. Always making sure we're stretching the chest with the back. A lot of times we really try to do a lot of opening up exercises, and we try to stretch out a lot of the back, but we don't concentrate on the chest enough. So if you're doing any myofascial relief on top of that, or you're doing any exercises, always make sure we're taking care of the front side just as much as the back side. All right, little quick one. We're just going to do 5 neck circles here. So we're just going to come down. One, and they're very slow here. We're not trying a speed race. 2, 3, I like to keep my eyes closed on this one. 4, keeps the dizziness down, right? And 5, bring it to neutral, open those eyes. I just want you to take your left hand and just kind of pull, put it on the right side of your head and just kind of pull over. We're not trying to yank the head down here. Just trying to give a little stretch in these side neck muscles here. 3, 2, and 1. Go ahead and slowly release. We don't want it to jerk back on us. We want a nice slow release. Let's go the opposite direction in those neck circles. I don't remember which way I went. Three, 4, and 5. Back to neutral. Right hand, left side of the neck. Two, one, release it nice and slow. Keep that hand on there until you're back to neutral spine. All right, so we're working our way down. Let's get into the hips a little bit. Hip flexors, glutes, big part of these stretches. We want to bring the hands, the foot up here to the knee. Now, if you have trouble with that, you can bring it lower, or you can bring it up to here. So if you can't quite get that foot up, start with straight. Put it as far as you can. Maybe you're down here. Maybe you're all the way up here, maybe you're here. That's fine, whichever way you are, you should take this opposite hand, press down on that knee until you feel some tension in that hip area. What this is gonna do, this is pulling on the hip, flexor and psoas muscles inside there, trying to invert them. We get a lot of hip pretty much locking up because our psoas and hip flexors are shortening from us sitting all the time. So this is inverting them. It's twisting the hip while we sit. Because then what we're going to do is we're going to stretch out this big old muscle in the back. That big old glute, right? We're going to grab on this and rotate glutes, hip flexor, both opposite muscle groups, but they both need to be accounted for. So this one, we're looking over our left shoulder as we're pulling up on that right knee. Could be the opposite there. The biggest thing here is to think of this as like wringing a towel, right? When we wring the towel out, we're pulling from both sides. This is the best way to stretch this muscle group. Everything is chain link and everything's going across the body. So when we want to get to one good muscle group, we want to stretch both sides so that we're kind of wringing out that towel, which is going to be our glute in the background. Let's go ahead and switch it up. Other side here. We're just pressing down. Always good to take 10 to 15 minutes during the day. Stretch out those muscles, stretch out those tendons and ligaments as well, and fascia that are really tightening up from us either sitting all day, driving all day, or staying stationary all day. But believe it or not, even if you're doing something consistently and you're up all day, but you're doing something consistently, stretching is still going to help that because we want to prevent that overuse injury as well. Underuse and overuse can still be helped by stretching. Let's go ahead and pull up now on that knee. Looking over, now I'm pulling on the left knee, looking over my right shoulder. I'm sorry, pulling up on the right knee with my left hand, looking over my right shoulder. Good. Feel that good glute pull right along here, right along that front, backside. 3, 2, and 1. Very good there. Let's go ahead and have a stand here. Nice and easy. Now, when we have that stand, right, these are the muscles, these hip flexors that are getting a little bit underused. They're what's shortening. So they're what we want to somewhat tighten. So I'm going to just pull this chair to the side. Now, I'm going to leave this chair here because this next exercise, we're going to go into a runner stretch. Some of you may have trouble getting down on the knees. I never want to put you in that predicament. So the chair can be used. I'm going to show you both ways. If you don't want to get down on the knees, the chair can be used for balance. And all we're going to do is step through. If you don't mind getting down on the knees, we're going to drop the knees. We're going to send that right, that left foot, in my case, past the knee. So you see the knee goes straight down. The foot is past the knee. Now I want to make that knee catch up to the toe. And I'm going to go right there. I can still use my chair for balance here, or I can put the hands right here. All right. The reason I like to use the chair for balance, because now we're going to get into the hip flexor. I want you to raise your right hand if you're stretching your left knee forward. Whatever arm you're raising, is going to be the same arm, same side as the leg that's back. Now, if you feel a little pinch in your back, that means you leaned back. We don't want to do that. We just want to lift the arm. We want to keep the chest straight, keep the back flat. Now, for folks that don't want to get down on that knee, it's the same process. Foot in front of the knee, lean it forward, use this chair or use something that gives you good balance. Same thing. All right, and you're trying to push those hips into the floor. Now, some of you might like this stretch better off the knee anyway. It's up to you. What do you feel more comfortable with as far as stretching goes? Trying to get that hip flexor opened up. That's our goal here. Let's go ahead and switch it up. I'll just turn around. Good. I'm going to do this one from the knee just to show you that base again. Foot forward, stretching forward. Oh, you can get that from some of that under the hamstring as well. Good stuff, right, folks? Lift that left arm up in my case because my right leg is forward. Doesn't matter which one you did first. We got to do them both. Good. And again, if you feel that lower back twinge, just lean forward just a little bit because what's happening is you're pinching at that back. So just kind of push that body forward a little bit because that we don't want that. We're pulling on that hip flexor. So if we lean back, it pushes the hips rotate a little bit. It pushes them up into that lower back process, and that's where we get a little bit of pain, a little bit of pinching. Wouldn't really call it pain, but a little bit of pinching. Never comfortable. Very good. All right, from here, what I want to do is I want to go down to the ground for this next stretch. So if you can make it to the ground with me, we're going to go on our backs. I'm going to go ahead and come right here. And we just want to take care of a little bit of lower back and a little bit of hamstring here. So what we're going to do is the first one is we're going to bring those knees to the chest. Lovely one, right? Anytime we're trying to stretch that back. I like to cross my legs. You don't have to. You can keep them separated. I feel like it just gives me a little bit more of a stretch. Now I want you to take a big inhale. Build that belly. Exhale, pull a little tighter. Do that a couple more times. See how tight you can bring those knees. And it's tougher to fill the belly the tighter you bring it. I understand that. But don't be afraid to just let those legs open up to fill the belly and then close them as you're pulling them in. Good. Hopefully you feel that good back stretch. You may feel even a little bit coming through the hamstrings if you're pulling on those knees. Good. 3, 2, 1. Let's go ahead and release that down. All we want to do here is reach as far as we can to the backside. So we want to keep those knees bent. You're just going to reach the hands as far as you can. Now what I want to do is slide the feet down to match that. And here, you want to just reach the toes, reach the hands, feel that little stretch. And then what I want you to do is hold it for 5 seconds here. 3, 2, and I don't want you to move anywhere. I just want you to relax. Don't try to push anything. 3, 2, 1. Now, can you get a little bit further? Now, reach the toes, reach the hands. Big stretch. 3, 2, and 1. Excellent. Now, I'm going to show you one that goes cross-body stretching. And you can use some a foam roller for this as an implement, but you don't have to. I'm going to show you how to do it without. But you're going to lay on your side here for me. Hand has come out so that we can make a bit of a clamshell here. And then what we're going to do with our legs, the bottom leg is straight. The top leg is going to come forward. Now, where I was talking about foam roller, you could put something to go under here so you have something to push down on. But you don't need it. It can just stay relaxed there. You can even straighten this out if you want. This is totally fine straight. I just like to keep my knee bent and keep it there. But if you want to just straighten this leg out, the big tip part is this bottom leg should stay straight with the head and toe. Heel to hip, back ahead. Head should be a straight line. All right. And then what we're going to do is you can also have something to rest the head on. But I've learned that I just kind of let it rest right on the bottom of that shoulder blade. I'm sorry, top of the shoulder. Hands are together. Reach that hand up as far as you can and then go as far over as you can. Now, leg, the toes cannot come off the ground. So I don't want to see this. All right? And if you're using the foam roller under that knee or any type of object like a pillow, you're pushing down into that and that wouldn't leave that object. So they stay planted into the ground or object. Now, once we're over here, all I want to do is take my hand, bend at my elbow, and try to touch it behind my head. So the hand straight like this. I'm just going to bend at my elbow, touch behind the head, and then back, and then we'll come back over top. All right, so let's try this all together. Here we go. 3, 2, 1. Let's rotate over. Nice, good stretch. Hold that there. 3, 2, 1. You should feel that in the chest. And then take that arm. You're still trying to push the elbow back. Reach behind the head. You'll feel a little bit of tricep in there. Good. Over. Good. We got one more on this side. Big reach. Head can be down now, right? It can be looking straight up into the ceiling. Everything, the toes planted. Let's reach behind the head. 3, 2, 1. And back over we go. All right. if we do one side, we must stretch the other. Push us up here. All right, so let's go ahead. Bring that leg forward. Head down. Reach it all the way over. Hold that. 3, 2, 1. Big scissor. Good. Behind the head somewhat. Really by next to the ear. Depends on how good flexibility you are, right? You may be able to get that hand all the way down. Reach it back over. Or, in my case, it's close. And then with pushing that elbow down, we're just going to reach. And let's bring it all the way over. Really good cross body stretch. Last one here. Reach it over. Nice and easy. Open it. Chest is open. Back is opened up. 3, 2, 1. Let's go ahead. Spin here. Bring it all the way over. What I like to do from here is I like to roll now on to the stomach and to the knees. Just do a quick little sit back, or what we call this, a child's pose, right? We want to just sit the hips back here. Just reach it forward. Take one big inhale. Let's go ahead and come up nice and easy. And now we can return to our day. A little bit more flexible, right? A little bit more calm. Stretching's good for us. Take 10 to 15 minutes every day. Stretch that body out. Keep that fascia moving. See you next time. Thanks, everyone. Thanks so much, everyone. Appreciate it. I love stretching, right? So good for us. Feels so good. And really concentrate on those hips and glutes. It'll really change your day. Have a great one, everyone.